Question is from Dave Colquitt. How do you work on keeping your feet and knees straight during a squat or deadlift? I've tried keeping them that way, but it's a lot more comfortable to point my toes slightly out.
You don't have to. Yeah. You don't have to point them. I remember when I first learned that and I thought, oh, everybody has to be. But when you look at anatomy and the different variances from individual to individual, you find that there are some things, there's a lot of things you can change. Mm-hmm. Your tissue pliability, extensibility, how it extends, how tight it is, how strong it is or stable it is. But there's some things you can't change, like your bone. Like you have a hip bone structure and the femur that fits in the hip and your joint and that structure. It's not going to change. It is the way it is. And if your joint is a particular way, it may actually be better for you to have your feet pointed out a little bit when you squat or when you deadlift. And for some people, it may be straight. You have to identify if it's a tissue issue or if it's a bone or joint issue. And sometimes it's a bone or joint issue.
I'm glad you went that direction because I'm going to go the other direction. The reason why I don't completely like that advice, even though it's true, is that people hear that and then they justify this extreme external rotation in their feet because they're so tight they can't get their feet straight. And I say this because this was me. If I were to squat, if you looked at my squat just 2 years ago, maybe three now, I had to have a really wide stance. My feet were pretty externally rotated. And it was just because I was extremely tight everywhere. And when I started to work on the 90-90, it really started to mobilize my hips, which the ability to mobilize the hips allowed me to rotate my feet in even more. So I think that, yeah, if you have a slight external rotation, that's okay. But I also want to be careful of telling people that, because then what ends up happening is you have these people that stand really wide open, and it's not because that's their anatomy. Mm-hmm. That, because if you have your gait, okay, it shouldn't be that far off from your gait. And if your gait, your feet are that wide open, that you have a problem. You're not walking properly if that's what your gait looks like. So we should be able to squat in the same position with our feet that we walk in our gait. Mm. Yeah. And if it's that wide open, I guarantee if you looked at that person's gait, they would be completely externally rotated, or what do they call it, duck feet out like that. And that is something that a lot of people can address and work towards. And a lot of that has to do with hip mobility.
Yeah, I think if you're a competitive power lifter, you're going to kind of know that a bit of external rotation is beneficial to you. You have, a sort of strength and comfort zone within the way that your feet are set up there. However, I personally tend to lean on the fact that we should be able to squat with multiple angles of your foot position. And I should have them in a narrow stance, and I should have them wide, and I should have them externally rotated, internally rotated. And so to limit yourself to justifying it based off of limb length or a lack of mobility there, I think is not really doing yourself the full justice. I think that maybe that's just because we need work, in that direction. We need to actually mobilize the hips or ankles more effectively. So that would be more of a revealing thing to me, that you have restriction versus maybe this is an anatomy issue.
Yeah, well, it depends on how much they're pointing out. He says toes slightly pointed out.
Right.
I'd like to see what the squat looks like. Yeah, yeah. Toes slightly pointed out sounds to me pretty normal. But he may be thinking it's slightly pointed out, and he may be doing what you're saying.
But I love what Justin's saying, because even to that point, because I do this. I will squat, with my feet completely straight and fucking 4 to 6 inches apart sometimes. Mm-hmm. And then I'll do a big wide sumo. Sometimes I will let my feet to come out. And so I think that's an excellent point. Why would you limit yourself to a exact, unless you're a power lifter, because that's different.
You're just trying to perfect the skill over and over again of that same position.
That's where, when you're a power lifter, you don't want to be messing with all these stances. You want to take the stance you're going to take every time you get under the bar for the lights to go, right? That's what you care about. It's performance-based. Totally different for the average person who's listening, who cares about just overall health, strength, and building muscle, those people, absolutely, you should challenge yourself to be able to squat with a narrow stance, a wide stance, your feet straight, your feet externally rotate a little bit. And I think that's a fucking incredible point, Justin.
Yeah, but I guess at the end of the day, work on practicing your squatting and work on your mobility. This is why it's a skill, because over time, you'll find as you improve on your mobility, your squat may start to look a little bit different, and it may start to feel more more comfortable over time. But ideally, I think that's great advice. Work on different stances unless you're a competitor.